right, so 1990, Piccolo Mondo, a 60-minute drive to the tiny disco dive where everyone from everywhere and anyone who loved anyone could truly for an evening feel alive. We danced a quick umbrella. We fold until we dropped. We couldn't tell the roosters from the hens. Nothing was forbidden. The pleasure never stopped. A little world turned strangers into friends. At the dawning of democracy in Chile, during Pinochet's last days, the policemen came and broke into our disco. They arrested all the gays. They tested every one of us for HIV. They did it for the sake of the community. But only two were positive. They had to let the other hundreds free. I told myself we shouldn't have to stand for this injustice. I told myself we shouldn't have to spend our lives in fear. We need to have a place where these results are confidential, where people who are hurting find a sympathetic ear. I'll talk about the tests and help them make their own decisions. I'll hold their hands and make them feel a little less alone. No government officials care enough to do it for us. I'm not a nurse or doctor, but I'll start it on my own. We fought for funding, we fought for our rights. We held a drag show to keep on lights. Through a tangled web of politics and clinics and in hospitals, I saw as many patients as I could. Over all of South America, I gave them back their dignity. I gave each minute to the greater good. So many thrived, but others left defeated. Some ailments of the spirit can't be treated. Valparaiso, decades later, Piccolo Mondo. No efforts to revive that tiny disco dive of anyone from anywhere, of anyone who loved anyone. Just two men from that evening still alive. No waiters serving cocktails, no voguing on the floor. Pink cancer took the roosters and the hens. The subject is forbidden, like atrocities of war. A silent generation of my friends. By counseling, you learn that any day could be your last one. So when I lost Ramon, I feared it might be my time too. I scaled the Andes Mountains and I sailed the South Pacific. I knew that leaving Chile was the only thing to do. Like all gay men who lived back then, I started my life over. Got hired by a clinic in my hometown, USA. The cure still isn't found. I may not be around to see it. Retiring, I deliver these last test results. Your test results today. New York City. second. Piccolo Mondo. You're terrified and shaking. You're only 22. You wonder what the envelope will hold. You think you're Captain Marvel. Years and years ahead of you. Your little world still waiting to unfold. All these medical advances in my lifetime, all that work to pave the way. Still no one is immune to senseless danger. We must fight it every day. So ask yourself, beyond the threat of HIV, are you prepared to stand with your community? Whether negative or positive, it's up to us to set each other free.